It's the Weather Channel's biggest hit series, Hurricane Hunters. Mondays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Well, as you watch your local on the 8th, check out this eyewitness photo. A summer afternoon storm came rolling in the Everglades, bringing this gorgeous lightning glow. Just again, very dangerous thing also to see, even out in the distance there. Now, you know, this Father's Day weekend, many dads will be, taking their fishing poles and heading out to the water. But along with the rest and relaxation comes the real threat of lightning.
That's right. And already this year, three fishermen have died. That's due to lightning strikes, both on boats and also on shore. One of the biggest dangers fishing poses, it's having little shelter. Meteorologist Julie Martin has more.
Lorenzo Magdaleno was a championship bass fisherman, but due to lightning, the 51-year-old veteran sportsman's life ended on the water.
He loved the kids, always teaching them how to bass fish, you know. Great guy. It's a big loss to the bass community.
Magdaleno and his partner were fishing in the Bass Federation's Southern Division Championship on Florida's Lake Okeechobee June 8th when lightning from a pop-up storm killed Magdaleno on his boat. His partner was knocked unconscious but survived.
Those anglers took every precaution. They stopped fishing. They got down in the boat. They let the storm pass. And then when they thought it was a safe amount of time, they even started the boat up and moved to a new location further away.
The death is a first in the Bass Federation's 45-year history. But according to the database, struckbylightning.org, lightning has killed 20 fishermen in the last 5 years on both land and water. Of this year's four lightning fatalities, three were fishermen.
When you're out on the water in a boat, you're really the highest object. All that flat water for miles and miles. And especially if you have masts that stick up, that may conduct some of the electricity, the charge up toward the top of the mast, maybe make you a little bit more vulnerable.
John Haywood knows what it means to have a close call with lightning. He shot this video from his boat near Pompano Beach, Florida, then took cover.
We kind of all huddled underneath the center console. It was like the only protection away from it, just to kind of, and we decided to point the boat in the quickest direction away from the storm.
But in Magdaleno's case, there was nowhere to hide.
It just goes to show that Mother Nature's in charge.
Close calls are often hard to predict. If you do get into trouble, the National Weather Service recommends getting back to shore into a safe building or vehicle as soon as possible. And if you're stuck on a boat, drop anchor and get as low as possible. I'm meteorologist Julie Martin, the Weather Channel.
And today on weather.com, you know, what are your odds? You can find out what areas are the five most lightning prone. We're looking at cities here. That's on weather.com.
New series that will blow you away. Pyros premieres Tuesday, June 19th at 9. Now you're local on the 8th.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, mainly clear skies, low 54. Sunday, a few clouds from time to time, high 76. Somewhere cold and caked in snow. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, I love stories that spark your creative side, and this one